I'm Nelson Coffin with the Varsity Sports Network, talking to Mount DeSales coach Trish Armstrong. After a huge win over previously undefeated in the league, St. Paul's, you guys are still undefeated in the IMB conference. Talk about the magnitude of this game, Trish.
This is huge. There's three of us going into this day that are undefeated. And this was the first of a tough week we had. St. Paul's, Maryvale's going to be a tough out on Wednesday, and then we go to Mount Carmel on Friday. So this is a big week for us. We came off exams. A lot of the girls were in D.C. with that rally. Yesterday, they didn't get in until 6, 7 o'clock. So we had one practice on Thursday. So I was a little concerned about it. I'm concerned because Pat does a great job with his kids, and they're a very good ball club.
Well, speaking of which, you guys had a big lead. We're talking about Pat Conrad, the St. Paul's coach. He threw a press on you guys, and with Abby Kuhn out of the game, it really was effective.
It was. It was a couple-minute period where we just had to weather the storm, get Abby back in, and adjust, and we made some big adjustments at halftime on what to do with the girls. It was a different look than they had seen all year. They came and trapped the girl, and then they flew in and tried to prevent the ball going back into Abby.
That's right.
So it was very effective, but everything was all up front when we made the adjustment. Once we got Abby in, it settled it down, and we made the adjustment at halftime, telling the girls everything was up top. You flash to certain areas on the court, and then you will beat it and get layups.
All right, let's talk a little bit. Now, even so, St. Paul's came back and took the lead in the third quarter. And you guys went on a 13-0 run. Kristen Zaransky had 11 of those 13 points, finished with a career-high 34. Talk about her and her. I mean, she's got this kind of push shot that goes. It's amazing.
Well, and another opponent last week tried to just take her out, Face Gardner. But then we beat that opponent handily because we have about seven or eight kids that can shoot.
That's true.
So today Kristen was open, but tomorrow maybe someone else. Kristen's a great player. Great player. She just, as you know, got her 1,000 point. And we're going to honor her at senior night with that.
She now has 1,014 points. Fantastic, right?
It's over 1,000. Yeah, I'm not sure exact. Yeah, she needed 20 to get it today.
Okay. And she got 34. And talk about Abby Kuhn, please, and her impact. She doesn't need to score.
Nope.
To make you guys better. Talk about her impact on the team.
Abby just controls the tempo. I mean, just like you saw when she was out. And normally Abby plays 30, 32 minutes a game, but she picked up that extra foul and we sat her, and it just caused a little havoc because they're so comfortable with her. She knows when to settle, all the right passes, all the right... See, these four of these girls have played together since they've been 10 years old, so they know each other in their sleep. And it makes a big difference. But Abby controlled the tempo. I think, if I'm right, they had that one-point lead. That was the only lead they had in the whole second half. They just got the one, and then that was it.
Could have been, yeah.
We went right up on that run, and then we held this up
and then
steady.
You really closed them out in the fourth quarter. But Pat Conrad was talking about your perimeter defense, how you were running them off the three-point line. Mm-hmm. They were taking these Steph Curry things. Okay. They're way back.
Right.
So... talk about your perimeter defense.
Dave and I had scouted them, and we told the kids they will launch that shot up. And we had scouted that they run that high ball screen up there, and they do a very good job on their offense. Pat's a great coach. I think it's a great team.
Well, congratulations on the win.
Well, thank you so much, and thanks for covering.
Absolutely.
Thank you.